طيب I'm going to go quickly over the ruqya from the Quran, the authentic ruqya from the Quran, and then after that we start the ruqya from the Sunnah. We said the ruqya from the Quran is, who's going to remind me? Fatiha first, second, Al-Baqarah, Ayat al-Kursi. Only two brothers answering. Let's hear from other people. Sheikh Zafar, what else? Ma'awudat, Falak wa Nas, Al-Ikhlas. We're coming to that today. Last two ayah of Surah Al-Baqarah. What else? And that's it. And that's it. So today, inshallah ta'ala, we'll do the ruqya from the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There were different du'as from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that can be used as a form of ruqya. And we explained last week that is a ruqya is usually either using the words of Allah azza wa jal or using the authentic hadith, authentic dua from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Abu Sa'id al-Khudri reported that Jibreel alayhi salam visited Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam while he was sick. And he, Jibreel يعني, performed or said this dua to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahu Akbar. Now when Abu Sa'id is narrating this hadith, did Abu Sa'id see Jibreel? No, right? What does that mean? That means Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa told him, Ya Abu Sa'id, Jibreel came to me and did this, right? Because I don't want somebody to say, because when you read it, Abu Sa'id al-Khudri reported that Jibreel visited, as if it looks like he saw Jibreel. No, he did not. So what was what was a ruqya that Jibreel alayhi salam used to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam? It is Bismillahi أرقيك من كل شيء يؤذيك من شر كل نفس أو عين حاسد الله يشفيك بسم الله أرقيك or أرقيك أرقيك بسم الله أرقيك by the name of Allah عز وجل I shelter you I perform this ruqya from all that hurt you from everything that is ailing you, from the evil of any soul, and that of the envious eye. May Allah cure you. With the name of Allah, I shelter you. Bismillahi arqiq, min kulli shay'in yu'dhik, min sharri kulli nafsin, aw ayni hasid, Allah yashfiq, bismillahi arqiq. Okay, so, if I have any, or you know what, let me finish because after this we're gonna, what are the things that we use when ruqya is needed? What do we use the ruqya on what? We will describe that in a few minutes, inshallah. The second one is the one we discussed many times before, and that is the one, أُعِيذُكُمَا بِكَلِمَاتِ اللَّهِ التَّامَّ مِنْ كُلِّ شَيْطَانٍ وَهَامَّ وَمِنْ كُلِّ عَيْنٍ Lam. This is, we said, that you make this dua for the protection of your children. And we said that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to make this dua for the protection of his grandchildren. And he said, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explained, Inna abakuma kana yu'awwidhu biha Ismail wa Ishaq. Indeed, your father, yani Ibrahim, used to shelter with this وَعِيدُكُمَا بِكَلِمَاتِ اللَّهِ التَّامَّ His children, Ismail and Ishaq. So when you do that to your children, you are using the same dua that Ibrahim, the father of Anbiya, used, and Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, the best of Anbiya, used. So يا أخوان, I do not see anyone who really loves his children and cares about them letting a day pass by without saying this dua. If you cannot or you have hard time memorizing the dua in Arabic, hold it, ya akhi, in your hand for the first few days. And after that, naturally, you'll be able to say it without looking. But When I hear this kind of protection from this dua, wallahi ya akhwan, I feel like very guilty if I do not perform it on my children. طيب. Now, what are the things that require ruqya? What are the things that require ruqya? What do I do ruqya on? What does the person have to go through for me to perform ruqya? Number one, against the shaitan. I can perform ruqya to protect my children, myself, my wife, my mother, whomsoever from the shaitan. Isti'adha is to verbally seek Allah's refuge from shaitan. It is an important defense against shaitan's harm and plotting. We are urged by the Quran and the Sunnah to constantly seek refuge with the shaitan. Anytime, ya akhi, anytime. Sometimes you get furious, you get extremely angry, and you're about to explode. The first thing that comes to your mind, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he saw two people fighting. One of them, he said that his veins were bulging because of anger. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam looked at the person next to him, he said, I know of a word of this man said it. If he said it, all his anger will disappear. So the man said, what is it, ya Rasulullah? He said, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. Now, where is the problem? Remembering to say, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. Remembering at that time when you are so upset and you're so mad and so angry, to remember to say أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. That's why when you see somebody يعني is about to explode or you know screaming and yelling, you come and remind him, because the shaitan is not going to remind him. He's taking over right now. You come, يا أخي استعذ بالله, استعذ بالله, say أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. Remind him, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. According to رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, you know, it will calm you down. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَإِمَّا يَنْزَغَنَّكَ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ نَزْغٌ فَاسْتَعِذْ بِاللَّهِ. This is an ayah. When an evil whisper comes to you from the shaytan, immediately say, فَاسْتَعِذْ بِاللَّهِ. Say, أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ. Surah, both in Araf and Fussilat. And in another place, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Mu'minun, وَقُلْ رَبِّ أَعُوذُ بِكَ مِنْ هَمَزَاتِ الشَّيَاطِينَ وَأَعُوذُ بِكَ رَبِّ أَيْ يَحْضُرُونَ. Those ayat, I heard the sheikh who does the ruqya, he says them when there is also jinn, because jinn is part of the shaitan. يعني we all know that the shaitan is from the jinn. So saying these ayat, when you think that there is a jinn in the person, that will also help بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. Second thing we use ruqya for is al-ayn, the evil eye. Envy is one of the greatest evils among Allah's creation. It is what caused shaitan to rebel against Allah's command. And it is what causes the people to make plots and inflict wars against each other. One of envy's ugliest manifestation is the evil eye. Al-ayn تدخل الرجل القبر والجمل القدر. The evil eye sends a man into his grave and a camel into a cooking pot. You know, this to show Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, when he said that, to show the power of the evil eye. The evil eye is so strong. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, العين حق. So whomsoever tells you, what is this evil eye thing? I don't believe in it. No. العين حق. The evil eye is absolute truth. It is definitely a reality. It العين حق فلو كان شيء سابق القدر سبقته العين. The evil eye is true, and if there is anything where to raise qadr, it would have been the evil eye. What does that mean? If there's anything to raise qadr, anything would raise qadr, it will be the evil eye. This is what Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said. What does that mean? This is an exaggeration. You know when you want to exaggerate about something to show how effective it is, how strong it is? Because the ayn is from the qadr, right? Right? Everything is from the qadr. So Rasulullah ﷺ said, if there's anything that will beat the qadr, it would have been the ayn. Like I tell you, listen, I'm going to find you even if you want to the sky. This is exaggeration. Even if you go under the earth, I'm going to find you. So similarly, Rasulullah is saying that the ayn is so true, is that it will get you. It will get you no matter what happens. Okay, as if it is beating the qadr, comes before the qadr. But you know, the qadr, the ayn is from the qadr. Sah. Okay. And another hadith, Rasulullah said, لا رقية إلا من عين أو حمى أو دم. Do not treat with رقية except for the evil eye, scorpion sting or bleeding. And we will come to the rest of them, inshallah ta'ala. Aisha reported that Rasulullah heard a child crying, constantly crying. So he said, مَا لِصَبِيِّكُمْ هَذَا يَبْكِي فَهَلَّ اسْتَرْقَيْتُمْ لَهُ مِنَ الْعَيْنِ. Why is this child crying? Wouldn't you seek to treat him with ruqya from the evil eye? So you know, sometimes, especially the newborn, if somebody has a newborn, they constantly cry in the beginning. Of course, it's normal, but at the same time, it will not harm at all. As a matter of fact, it will benefit. You put your right hand on that baby, and you read the surahs that we mentioned, or the du'as that we mentioned from the sunnah. Sahl ibn Hanif, this is a very famous hadith about the evil eye. Sahl ibn Hanif reported that he was once traveling with the Prophet ﷺ. During one of their stops, Sahl took a bath. Amir bin Rabi'ah saw him and, on observing the whiteness of his skin, exclaimed, by Allah, I never saw before this day a skin like this smooth, like a virgin's skin. Immediately, Sahl was struck with a seizure and fell sick. Very famous hadith. So Sahl was showering in the public. And of course, he had his awra covered, but his top part was showing. So this sahabi, I said, I've never seen something so smooth or so clean or so white or whatever. He just exclaimed without saying, MashaAllah, Tabarakallah. You know, he did not mention Allah Azza wa Jal. So Sahl was struck. He immediately fell and extremely sick. So when the Prophet ﷺ learned about this, he asked the companion, هَلْ تَتَّهِمُونَ أَحَدٍ. Do you suspect anyone? And how did this happen? Do you suspect anything? They said, Ya Rasulullah, Amr. We suspect Amr bin Rabi'ah. So Rasulullah ﷺ asked for Amr to come. And he addressed him angrily. He said, عَلَى مَا يَقْتُلُ أَحَدُكُمْ أَخَاهُ أَلَّا بَرَّكْتْ اِغْتَسِلْ لَهُ. Why would any one of you kill his brother? Look at the term Rasulullah used. Why would someone kill his brother? Shouldn't you have invoked Allah's blessing? Shouldn't you have said, he said in Arabic, أَلَّا بَرَّكْتَ أَلَّا بَرَّكْتَ لَهُ. Didn't you say, Tabarakallah, Barakallahu lak, Barakallahu alayk, Barakallahu feek? Any kind of barakah? Made dua for, may Allah put barakah in your health and your body and whatever. Allah barakta lah, igtasil lah. Wash yourself for his sake. What does that mean? So Amir washed his face, hands, elbows, knees, the sides of his feet, and his inner thighs. The water dripping from his limbs during the washing was collected in a bucket. A man then took the bucket, stood behind Sahl, and poured the water over his head and back. Sahl immediately stood up, cured. This hadith is reported by Malik and Ahmed, and very well known prescription for the cure from the ayn. If you know who is that person, if you know the person who did this to you, sometimes it's known. Most of the time it's not known, right? But sometimes it's known. If it is known, don't, because sometimes the person afflicted by the evil eye, they cannot move, they constantly cry, they constantly sick, they cannot function. So it's really a very serious issue. So it's not really a matter of being shy to go ask the person for, please, if it reached that point, go ahead and ask, ya akhi. If you do not know, then you do not know and you seek the other form of ruqya. But if you know that person, you ask him to make wudu, and from the water of the wudu, inshaAllah ta'ala, you take it and you throw it on the person, and bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, as we have seen. Of course, this has been told by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now, if someone say, what kind of talk is, what is the water from the shower is going to do to the person? If you do not believe in this, how come you believe in the ayn by to start with? The ayn itself, how did you believe that the ayn will harm somebody? So this, just like you believe that the ayn will harm someone, you believe that this will cure the ayn. Because all of this is from the ghaib. Right? Rasulullah ﷺ told us this. Where did Rasulullah ﷺ come up with something like this? Where did he come up with this? This is a very well-known cure from the ayn. There are the following lessons in this hadith. First, if the person who struck with his eye is known, he should be ordered to take a bath. This bath is useful in deleting the evil. An evil's eye stroke can be caused by mere admiration if there's no envy involved. A person who likes something should rush to invoke barakah for that thing. This would act as a ruqya from him against himself. The evil eye, and the last lesson is, the evil eye can kill. This is the comment of Ibn Hajar on this hadith. He said the evil eye can actually kill someone. Can actually kill someone. So he said that you could use ruqya for to seek refuge from the shaitan, for the evil eye. Third, from ulcer. Many people have ulcers, right? They have the sickness of ulcers. A man from the Ansar was once afflicted with ulcers on his sides. He was told of a woman called Ash-Shifa who performed ruqya for that. He went to her and asked her to treat him. But she refused, saying, "By Allah, I have not performed any ruqya since embracing Islam." He went to Rasulullah ﷺ and mentioned this to him. The messenger asked her and said, "A'rudi alay, present your ruqya to me." She did. And he said approvingly, "Urqih, treat him with this ruqya and teach the ruqya for ulcers to Hafsa, just as you taught her to write." Okay, this woman looks like she taught Hafsa how to write. So he told her, teach her also this ruqya for ulcers. So there is a ruqya for ulcers. What is that ruqya? Allahu A'lam. This ruqya is not documented in the sunnah, but at least we learn that it's possible to cure ruqya, to cure ulcers with ruqya. I can use any of the previous ayat or surah or hadith or dua. Any general pain or any sickness, we can use ruqya for that. That does not mean, ya akhwan, I do not take medicine or I do not go to the doctors or I do not go to the hospital. No, I seek that and I seek this inshallah ta'ala. But when I seek this, if I do this first, it will be much better because that will show how strong is my connection with Allah Azza wa Jal. Stings and bites. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the hadith of Buraida indicates that stings are among the things that may be treated with ruqya. Anas reported, رخص رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم في الرقية من العين والحمى والنملة. Allah's messenger permitted using ruqya from the evil eye and from the scorpion's poison and from ulcer والنملة. Another thing we use ruqya for is insanity. Insanity. If someone is going crazy, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he also recommended that so you could use ruqya on them. Protection from fear. Abdullah ibn Amr reported that Rasulullah ﷺ used to teach them to say the following words in the situation of fear. أعوذ بكلمات الله التامة من غضبه وشر عباده ومن همزات الشياطين وأن يحضرون. I seek refuge in Allah's complete words from His anger, from the evil of His creation, and from the spurring of the devils, and that they present and that they be present with me. All that is in case there is fear. You use this dua, inshaAllah ta'ala, as a ruqya. Protection from harmful creatures. Rasulullah ﷺ said, "من نزل منزلا فقال أعوذ بكلمات الله التامات من شر ما خلق لم يضره شيء حتى يرتحل من منزله ذلك." This is very important. A lot of our brothers, they travel a lot. All the IT guys, they travel a lot. So every time you land in the airport, أعوذ بكلمات الله التامات من شر ما خلق. What happened? Whoever says that, Rasulullah ﷺ said, these will be complete words from all that protect me. Ya Allah, I seek refuge in Allah's complete words from all that He created. Nothing will harm him As long as he stays in that place, nothing will harm him or her as long as he or she stays in that place. أعوذ بكلمات الله التامات من شر ما خلق. We all know that. You say that also at night, 3 times in the adhkar of the masa. Suhayb reported that as soon as Rasulullah ﷺ saw a town that he intended to enter, he would say a dua of entering and protection from the evil of a new town. اللهم رب السماوات السبع وما أضلل ورب الأراضين السبع وما أقلل ورب الشياطين وما أضلل ورب الرياح وما ذرين أسألك خير هذه القرية وخير أهلها وأعوذ بك من شرها وشر ما فيها. O Allah, Lord of the 7 heavens and all that they cover, Lord of the 7 earths and all that they carry, Lord of the devils and all they misguide, Lord of the wind and all they scatter, I ask you for the good of this town and the good of its people, and seek refuge with you from the evil of this town and the evil of its people. And finally, subhanallah, this is something for all of us that you could use on a daily basis. And ya akhwan, this is very simple. It's very few words. Rasulullah ﷺ, he said, the narrator of this hadith is Uthman bin Affan radiallahu anhu. He reported that Rasulullah ﷺ said, ma min abd يقول في صباح كل يوم ومساء كل ليلة بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم 3 مرات فيضره شيء. No one, nothing would harm a person who says 3 times in the morning and 3 times in the evening بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم. 3 times he said, if you say that, no harm will take place during the whole day. Nothing will harm you. طيب يا أخوان, how long will this take? Let's time it. بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم. بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم. بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم. 30 seconds. 20 seconds. لا إله إلا الله. 20 seconds full protection the whole day إن شاء الله. So يا أخوان, if anybody does not know how to say this dua, does not have it, please let me know. I would love to give it to you إن شاء الله تعالى. And if I could teach it to you, whatever, any way I can gain حسنات, I'm ready إن شاء الله تعالى. So please, teach this to your children. It's a very simple dua. And if you teach them at a young age, it will stay with them, inshallah ta'ala, forever. So these are some of the ruqya that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, subhanallah, يعني, how beautiful is this deen? And there is nothing, nothing except Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam have taught us. Nothing you could think of, how to protect ourselves, what to say when you enter the bathroom, what to say when you approach your wife, what to say when you rule a country, how do you rule a country, how do you operate, how do you do anything, subhanallah, protection from scorpion bites, protection from ants, protection from anything that will harm you, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam have taught us. So, alhamdulillah rabbil alameen, we are so blessed, we are so grateful to Allah Azza wa Jal that He gave us this gift of Islam without doing any work for it. What did you do? What did you do to become a Muslim? Nothing. You know how many people when they discover it at a later age, they are so bedazzled, they are so blown away because they saw something that, you know, exactly what the ayah said. من الظلمات إلى النور. You know when you're sitting in a room, like imagine you have a room this big and you have no clue. It's all completely, you put your hand like this, you don't see your hand. Complete darkness. And you've been looking for the door for 10 years. You can't find the door, ya Sheikh. You're looking, and then all of a sudden one guy came, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came and put the light on. Now everything is clear. Now you know where the exit, where the entrance, you know everything, subhanAllah. This is exactly the example of our deen with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He came and he put the light on so we could see where are we going. أفمن شرح الله صدره للإسلام فهو على نور من ربه. May Allah put the nur in our hearts. May Allah put the nur in our homes, in our life. May Allah put the nur in our qabr. May Allah give us the nur on the day of judgment. May Allah give us the nur when we cross the sirat. Ameen, ya Rabbil Alameen. May Allah protect you all and protect your homes and fill your homes with love and mercy and tranquility. Ameen, ya Rabbil Alameen. Wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك.